Our top story tonight, State Senator Jeff Denham's fight to keep his job. It's getting a whole lot tougher. That's because some familiar political faces may be jumping at the chance to fill his seat even before it's empty. We now know that the June 3rd primary ballot will not only include the option to vote on a recall measure that would throw him out of office, but also to vote for candidates to replace him. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live in our Salinas newsroom with this Commitment 2008 report.
Aaron, those two issues will be on the ballot, and candidates who want to give Jeff Denham a run for his money, well, they have until 5 o'clock Saturday to get into the race.
Better vote yes on the recall.
I haven't even seen it.
But Denham's not backing down. He says voters will appreciate his track record and hard work, and he's not scared of facing the vote.
I still plan on being on the ballot on June 3rd. Going in front of the voters is something that's very acceptable to me. I've got a great record, and people I think will come out very positively to support me.
Just in case they don't, other familiar political faces may be waiting in the wings.
I've got to decide whether it really makes sense for the district or the Senate district as well as for me personally. And so I'm looking at a number of different things, and I probably should have a decision by tomorrow.
Assemblywoman Anna Caballero says she's happy with her current role and is deciding whether she wants to deal with a rushed two-month campaign. The recall will be added to the statewide June 3rd primary.
First, there will appear a question, shall Senator Jeff Denham be recalled from the State Senate District 12 office, and then a yes or no.
Then voters will have another choice to make. If Denham's out, who's in?
You know, I think that there will be many opportunists that take a look at this just as they have in other elections. You know, I'm going to continue to run on my record.
And since we talked to the Monterey County Elections Department earlier this evening, their website has updated and now lists Republican John Neville as the first candidate to have been issued nomination papers for that 12th district seat. Erin.
All right, Brittany, thank you. All voters will be able to vote for any candidate regardless of party affiliation.